lost count of the times I said the word frustrating in my commentary tonight. I imagine you felt much the same.
Yeah, I was disappointed with the performance. I mean, I knew it wasn't going to be an easy game. I watched our game against the Cheltenham. Spends a lot of time at play. The game gets slowed down. So it was a frustrating game. It's a frustrating game to watch. But I was more disappointed with the decision making from our players today. Certainly the younger ones, there's always that question mark. It's new to them and how they handle this situation. And I just didn't feel for what they've done previously, they didn't live up to their standards.
Was it the decision making with Mansfield being down to 10 and how you set about trying to exploit a space that may be there?
It's always difficult when when you're up against 10 men because they just slow the game down. It was a sending off. Someone else led with an elbow, but I explained to the lads that's what it was going to be like, and they had to stand up to that battle. And I didn't feel some of them were strong enough in that battle to be able to ride that through. But at least they know what the situation is now with the away performances that we've got, because it's not going to be easy.
So I guess some of them will have learnt the lesson tonight and can only improve because of that.
Yeah, massively. The other week, Ryan Hedges has never played extra time, so it's a little bit unknown for me, some of them, when they turn up in these, with this environment, against a physical team that's direct, throws balls into the box, direct in every part of their game, and you have to stand up to that, because that's part of their game plan, and they're good at it.
We can see from our high vantage point, what happened to Nathan Smith, and how is he had prolonged treatment?
Yeah, he's got stitches. Again, it's nothing. It's what I expected here tonight, to be honest. And you've got to deal with it. So, hopefully, we'll be able to get him stitched up and be able to get him back on the pitch as soon as possible.
So he had a head injury and wasn't able to continue. And what's the situation with Ryan Dixon? Because he went off quite early in tonight's game.
Yeah,
as well.
Dick will come off with an ankle. And he was feeling it. He took a knock on Saturday. It was quite a bad knock. But unfortunately, it's one of them where you have to. I thought Butcher had done well at left back, really well. I was really pleased with Butcher. I thought he'd done very well. I thought Alex Lacey controlled it. I thought we gave possession away in one or two areas of the pitch, which again, don't come from that. But we keep going and we regroup, and I'm looking for a reaction on Saturday.
Alluded to the mistake, there's obviously the mistake of giving the possession away, then the mistake that led directly to the penalty. I mean, was it only going to be a mistake that would cost you the game? Otherwise, it would have been 0-0 and you would have got a point.
Yeah, it's a fine line between winning and losing every week. And when you look at one or two of the play that we had, it was, I think we put like 48 balls in the final third. So it wasn't like we didn't have possession, it was just we couldn't break them down. And every time the ball went out of play, they slowed it down, which you would do. And they're just a physical, direct team. And our players didn't really deal with that.
Managed to get Francois Oko back on the pitch. That must be positive for you as he builds towards full fitness.
Yeah, it's good to have Francois back. I think he's an important player. And he puts other pressure on other players, though, because they're not going to accept that performance every week. They've got to get used to it, and it's going to happen because there's a lot of players now where their positions up for grabs on Saturday, and then we go to Everton.